this beautiful space and kind of looking around. And, you know, it was really kind of striking because the first quote that I read there from George Washington, I think, is apt. There is nothing which can better deserve our patronage than the promotion of science and literature. And I think that actually says quite a lot about what you want to know about the values that liberal arts institutions have. And Pomona is, of course, no exception. We value science and literature and many other disciplines equally across the board, and I'll talk to you about that a little bit. But first, I want to show you a really pretty picture. This is Pomona. We are at the base of the San Gabriel Mountain Valley, and so the other two schools, those reps who talked before me, they're great people. They have snow that actually touches you. At Pomona, we just have snow that you can look at. So it's never going to touch you. That's like 3,000 feet. You're never going to touch that. Because we are in Los Angeles. So we're in LA and Los Angeles County. And Los Angeles County is a very large place. LA is the second largest city in the United States. The county of Los Angeles has about 10 million people in it. So anything you can find in the US, you can find some version of that in Los Angeles. Pomona is actually located in the town of Claremont, California. And Claremont, California has about 35,000 residents. It is what in the US we say, it's a classic college town. It is absolutely designed for students in about every way. There's about 35,000 people there. It's pretty white collar. A lot of doctors, lawyers, dentists. It's definitely a destination town in the area, but it's really about the college students. And that's because when you walk downtown in downtown Claremont, there's lots of smoothie shops and bookstores and coffee shops, and everything has free Wi-Fi. You can use your ID to pay for stuff with Claremont cash. Over 50 different vendors in Claremont take your ID, you put cash in your ID, you literally need money. So it's really designed for students. And the reason is because Pomona is not the only college in town. You may have heard of some of our sister schools. Pomona is the founding member of the Claremont Colleges. And we have some other schools that live in Claremont with us. So Claremont Mechanic College, Scripps College, Harvey Mudd College, and Pitzer College. And together with Pomona, we form what is called the Claremont Colleges, or the Claremont Consortium. And the idea is very simple. You attend one school, but you can take classes at any of the schools. You live at one school, but you can participate in extracurricular activities at any of the schools. So you really get this great opportunity to be in a place like Pomona with 1,600 students. And at the same time, and at the same time, you get the opportunity to be part of the consortium where there are just over 6,000 students. Pomona offers about 800 courses, but within the consortium, there's over 2,000 courses that you can take. Pomona has 3 dining halls. You can eat on any of the dining halls at any of the Claremont colleges. There are 7. There's 2 major orchestras. There's one based in Garrison Theater at Scripps. There's another entirely different and equally well-sized orchestra based at Pomona. Lots of different opportunities, both to be a small school, because we have an average class size of 15 and a student-to-faculty ratio of 8-to-1, and to be in a medium-sized university setting where there's lots of different opportunities for you and different faculty to meet. So for example, there are 5 math departments in Claremont. That means that there's over 45 different math faculty in Claremont, which is really the size of a very large research university's math department. So we think a lot about what it means personal, but also what it means to be a little bigger and how we can take advantage of that size. Pomona itself has lots of sort of different ways to be a student. There's 48 different majors on campus. You major in one of 4 areas. You either major in the natural sciences, in the arts and humanities, in the social sciences, or in what we would call ID, or interdisciplinary studies. And so when you look on the list of majors, and the 48 majors in the booklet, you'll see some majors have the word studies after them. So you'll see Middle Eastern studies, or you'll see religious studies, or you see Asian American studies. All of those are what are called interdisciplinary majors. Another example of an interdisciplinary major might be environmental analysis, which combines environmental science and mathematics. We have another major called PPE, politics, philosophy, and economics. That's kind of the closest thing to a triple major. It's not really a triple major, but it allows you to study all three of those things. So if you're really into economics and you also really like philosophy, you can actually combine them into one area. You can do a single major, you can do a double major, you can do a major and a minor. There's lots of different possible combinations. Faculty are gonna work with you on that. We have one of the largest private libraries in the West, Honnold Library, which sits at the center of the Claremont Colleges and actually shared by all of the institutions. And you know, the campus itself is gorgeous. This is Marston Quad. This is sort of our big green space. That's a social science building there, Carnegie, which is the big white building there. But you'll see faculty hosting classes outside. You will see people walking, running, biking, or if you're really Californian, skateboarding through campus. And you are going to be able to have that life outside and inside because the weather's fantastic and the opportunities on campus are pretty high in number. So maybe this will. Okay. I can project, that's fine for a few minutes. So the average class size, as I said earlier, is 15. The student faculty ratio is 8 to 1. And in addition to that, you also have lots of different possible combinations when it comes to things like research as well as internships. This happens to be our new math and physics building. So a couple of years ago, Pomona ran what was called a capital campaign, which means that we raised a bunch of money for various things. We raised about $315 million. And with that money, we built a lot of new buildings. We built a studio art building. Right about the same time, we were building a new math and physics building. Why did we do that? Because the president wanted to show that science is just as important as arts and literature, right? So the idea that we're building new buildings, whether you are a studio art major, or you are a physics major, or a math major, whether you are studying visual art, or whether you are studying the solar system, you get a new classroom, you get new space. All those resources are the same. So our largest two majors last year, for example, were economics and mathematics.
And of course, those majors are gonna have lots of access to lots of faculty and be well supported. But other majors that are a little smaller, like maybe music or philosophy, equally strong resources, equally great support for students coming through. This is a drama faculty member, but just to highlight again the small classes, lots of intimate relationships. About 70% of faculty live within 5 miles of Claremont, and that really allows you to be able to meet with them frequently. They hold office hours, and they engage with you quite frequently. And whether it is the arts or extracurricular activities like Model United Nations, or possibly debate or speech and debate. Maybe you're interested in a cultural organization. Yes, there is a Vietnamese student club of the Claremont Colleges that you can join. There's also lots of trips. We have alternative spring breaks. Last year we had free trips available for community service over spring break to San Francisco, San Diego, Los Angeles, in downtown LA, as well as Houston, Chicago, and Miami. So lots of different ways to sort of get out and see the world and do things. I think whenever you are thinking about events and things like that, there's dance clubs on campus, orchestras. If you play an instrument, maybe you're really good at the violin or you play the bassoon, you can play in chamber ensemble. You can also play in the orchestra. Last year, the chamber or the glee club, which is the instrument, the vocal instrumental, the vocal club, They went on a trip to Italy that Pomona paid for. So there's about 20 members of the Glee Club. It's run by a woman named Donna DeGrazia. And they do an international trip usually every year, every couple years, And Pomona funds that. So there's a lot of ways to really be engaged. And I think this is the new studio art hall. I couldn't resist the picture, it's nice. But I put this slide up here because I think this is also quite illustrative of Pomona. That's the train that takes you into downtown LA. So it's about 35 minutes. It's pretty affordable. You can go to Chinatown or Olvera Street, sort of the old kind of original part of LA in downtown Los Angeles. That is Bob Gaines, who's a geology professor. Pomona has a world-class geology program. We're the only undergraduate institution that has an isotope lab, which means that we can take a rock from out on the street and you put it under a laser and it tells you how old it is. Most of those machines exist in large research universities, but Pomona has its own. Geology is a kind of medium-sized science major department. It's not our largest science department, but they also have great resources. That's a student who interned at The Daily Show with Trevor Noah. And then we have a garden on top of Sontag Hall. So being in California, we do think a lot about environmentalism and sustainability, and those things are important to us. Many students are going to do internships. Many students are going to do research. We have two specific programs. One of them is called the SERP, the Summer Undergraduate Research Program. It gives students grants of up to $5,000 to stay on campus and work with a professor or work on a project on your own. So last year we had students doing everything from Latin translations of French monks to research in a biology lab working on new ways to deliver drugs in the Ball Lab, which is a chemistry lab run by Professor Ball at Pomona. So really, lots of opportunities there. We also have internship opportunities, so students are able to apply for funding to have Pomona pay your wage while you do a summer internship. So actually, we had a great woman, Laura Zhang, who works in our office. She actually came to Hanoi. Pomona gave her $4,000 to come to Hanoi. She worked in a mobile HIV clinic that went around Hanoi and did HIV education and testing. She was here for 6.5 weeks. The organization was part of the World Health Organization, but they couldn't fund her. So they said, we'll give you a job, but we can't pay you a wage. So Pomona paid her wage, and the World Health Organization gave her a job. So we were really able to connect students with the things that they really want to do, which is super important. Last couple of slides here. I think we've all talked about being part of the global community. Pomona is anywhere between 12 and 13% international in any given class. We recruit all over the world. This is actually my third time in Hanoi in a year and a half, so I've actually been back to Vietnam quite a lot. And we all three are very committed to that global community piece. But we also know that it requires going out there and recruiting and really telling students we want you to be on our campus. I'll end with this slide, which I think is pretty great. That's one of our 9 different a cappella groups on campus. So if you sing, if you're really into singing, but you don't want to sing in the glee club, you can sing in the a cappella group. That is a basketball game. Basketball is a huge deal at Pomona. So the way that sports work, and that's the volleyball team there, Pomona College and Pitzer College form one varsity team. Claremont McKenna, Harvey Mudd, and Scripps form another varsity team. So, as you can imagine, we are arch rivals, and when we play each other, it's a really big deal, and students go inside and they scream really, really loud. You cannot hear anything when Pomona Pitzer and CMS are playing. And they're actually both pretty good, so it's pretty fun to watch. That's Phil Choi. He's the head of the physics department. His research actually focuses on exoplanets, so he spent his summer on a telescope in Hawaii looking at stars, trying to figure out if there are other Earths on campus, and he has lots of students who work with them. And then there's just a great shot of some students looking very happy, because I think most students at Pomona are very happy. So with that, I will bring my colleagues back up, and we will move over to Q&A and hopefully talk about some things that are on your mind. Thank you for your attention, and we'll move into part 3.